Alright, welcome everyone to the next episode of our playthrough of Pokémon Brilliant Diamond. So where we left off last time, we were taking on Gardenia in the second gym. We lost the first time just down to a close battle with her Roserade at the end, but we ended up getting through the second time with a little bit of help from some super potions on our Zubat, and then we ended up finishing it off with a Geodude of all sorts. Thanks to Geodude's sturdy ability, so that even though it probably would have been one hit if it didn't have that, being that it's a rock type going up against a grass type, we managed to get through it. So now we're going to head up to the top of the map, as I said in the previous episode, because we're going to come across a familiar face, a bit of a fan favorite from this generation. And here she is. Cynthia. So now that we've got that, we have a galactic building right here. Thanks to a wild Bidoof, it opens it up to us. And let's go see what's going on in here. I can't battle him. Alright, we can battle these two. In just one sec, my audio switched off. I really need a different move for the non-grass type moves for Grottle, so he's actually useful against bug and grass types if we do come across any. And I'm really looking forward to coming across a fire type as well to add to the team, because that will be a big advantage. I'm half tempted just to go a little bit further ahead in Pearl and breed my Chimchar and trade it over. If we don't really see that many fire types. But I think it might be worthwhile adventuring through the Grand Underground to see what fire types we can come across down there to add to our team. I will be interested to know whether the catch rate is just really hard on them at the moment because of like the how high level they are compared to like what I was coming up against. We'll see it again when we get down there. But I certainly experienced that in my Pearl playthrough, where like they were like level 29 and I had level 22 and 23 Pokemon, and they were one hit KOing us and not staying in Pokeballs at all. And that's the only time I've actually whited out in that Pearl playthrough so far, just because I think I tried to run on the last Pokemon, it said I couldn't get away, and then it one hit KO me, which was unfortunate. Poisoned. Funny how they have all the same reactions when they lose. Alright, up we go. No one to really battle through here. Oh, these edges. Good, before it could start using Harden and being annoying to beat. Down it goes. And what's the last one going to be? Zubat. Right. Down you go. Yeah, I was listening to a podcast this morning where they were... It's super effective podcast, and they're doing like a little breakdown of Diamond and Pearl. And I was just listening to their initial episode because they're doing like a episode a day or something like that as they get through the game, and they're going through the game much faster than I am. So I don't want to spoil anything for myself in the future. So I decided to start listening to their first episode, which went through like up to the first gym, and I just wanted to hear their initial impressions. And they seem to like it so far, other than pointing out that the start of the game is almost slower to get going than Sun and Moon is, and Sun and Moon is notorious for having like cutscenes that can't be skipped, and making it, I think they made it really hard to like reset to check for shiny starters, unless it was either that or they'd locked the starters so they couldn't be shiny potential. But yeah, it was interesting, like, listening to them talk about it, and they pointed out that it was a little bit weird in terms of the overall controls, and, like, I think I commented in my first episode how I liked the feeling of the movement, but I've almost come to notice what they were talking about as well, where it was, it's almost, there's just something slightly off with the movement. Maybe it is due to how, there's no hold down a button to run instead, so like having it all in the same joystick makes it feel a bit weird, and I certainly feel that, but yeah, it's slightly off and no one can really work out what it is. Flamethrower, wow. Uh-oh. Someone's gonna faint because of poison. Don't want to throw a Grottle out there because it'll just use Flamethrower and that'll be... awful. Which one? Yeah, Smackdown. Here we go with the speed issue again. I just don't think my team's very good at the moment, to be honest. I was listening to the teams that they had picked out, and they were very... I think they'd gone with like a Shinx like I had. But they'd gone with the Bidoof, and they'd avoided things like Geodude. One of them had grabbed an Abra. Oh man, forgot about that. Right. Yeah, I don't really have... Teleport's not going to do anything either, so I guess that's just a... that's an easy win for them. I've got two different grass types to throw out. I don't have much confidence in either of them. Well, that was a given to happen. Just take this opportunity to get rid of the poison status on there. I'm hoping that since Flamethrower didn't do a hell of a lot against Badu, then hopefully it doesn't do much against us. Oh, that hurts. Alright, let's see how Tackle goes instead. Just as bad. Right. Oh man, I'm gonna lose again. This is so embarrassing. Can I be paralyzed? Yes, good. Nope, game over. Man. I really need to go ahead and improve my team, because, yeah, this is making me look really bad. I really should have done it differently where I went with Chimchar for this playthrough, huh? That would have been a bit better. Who knew picking Turtwig and then picking the team that I picked would make this so difficult? The worthwhile going out and seeing what else I can find. I don't think this guy's going to let us out. Oh no, he is. Alright. Yeah, let's see what we can encounter out here. Yeah, there's no point in going with a Pachirisu because we've already got an electric type. Catch it anyway because we're looking to finish the Pokédex, but yeah. I think the selection of Pokémon that they give you in the initial stages does make it a little bit difficult in terms of like having a good roster. Nope, and send you to the box. Let's see what else is out here. Oh, some berries. Maybe it might be worthwhile. I know we've already got one, but this one's higher level than the one that we caught before. Hey, here we go. Yep, so let's get rid of Tackle. And teach it Bite, that might actually help us out quite a bit. No, I didn't want to do that. Add to party, and let's swap out... yeah, let's just replant some berries, shall we? So, I think we'll be fine this time around, because, yeah, I just think having Bite on Grottle might help a little bit, even though I think Skun Tank is a dark type. Yeah, well, might still come in handy. And we'll leave Bidoof in the team until we come across with something better. But just, yeah, having two grass types doesn't really make sense. Oh dear. I can't believe we are having such a hard time with this. What is going on? It's faster than me. This is madness. And I'm burnt. Great. Oh, man. Oh, this is painful. Yep. And I'm dead, and then I've got a Bidoof. Wow, okay. Okay, this is really annoying. Let's just have a look at our box and see what we've got in here. Okay, let's add you to the team and toss out Kadabra. Let's add you to the team and toss out Bidoof. Instead of, I don't know, Geodude actually did some decent stuff. I don't know, let's just take on these guys for a bit. Man, that scum tank is as tanky as anything. I don't know how much EXP we're gonna get from these guys anyway. I want to go and pick up the old rod as well. Just don't know where it is. Old Rod is located just west of Jubilife City in one route of the. Okay. Ah, Starly. Now, why was it that I was electing to go with one and not the other? Like, I know I caught the Zubat and I want to have a Crobat on the team. But I don't understand why, I kicked Starly out. Because, yeah, it's two flying types, but I feel like they're both useful. Like, for all we know, it could actually be helpful against Skuntank. helpful it will be, obviously, to... So I'll definitely go and get the old rod at some point. And then that could potentially be our water type for the team. Whatever we can get through there. This is not giving us much EXP at all. I wish they had stuff other than Magikarps. Okay, that's you done. What are you gonna have? He's only got one. Yeah, that's a gold bean, alright. That's a bit better. Okay, so we can't battle you. Interesting. Alright, so since we have cut, I think we can just skip through the interior of the forest. Ooh, berries. I might come back and plant some stuff. Ooh, can we battle you? No. Oh, thank you. Stickers. Alright. There's a tree there. Route 205. Right. Wait, I don't think we battled you. No, we didn't. Yeah, best just gain some EXP before going back. did we battle this person? Yeah, I guess we did. Let's just go in here and heal ourselves quickly. Thank you. There's an item here. Oh, so it's a Pokeball. Yeah, okay. One more battle and then we'll head back and see how we go this time. Or do I want to run back and get the hold rod? Yeah, we'll do that. Yeah, this will be a slightly longer episode than normal. Yeah, let's do bite. Shield in the battle? Alright, one more. And yeah, that was the other thing they said on the podcast, that there wasn't much diversity amongst the teams, which is quite true, because if you think about everything that we've encountered through here, it jumps between Shinxes, Badoos, Geodudes, Pachirisus, and Zubats, I think. Annoying poison point, huh? Huh? Oh well, at least we're making our money back from all these losses that we've had, huh? What's this dude doing? Oh, yeah. It's telling us that, so then if we go this way... cut through here. Should just be a very quick detour. I think it's this way? No. This way. This guy. If only we had fly, huh? I wish these things just stayed smashed. sprinting all the way back. Oh, whoops. Oh dear. Yeah, let's go up to a grass type if this guy's just gonna be building up his defense like that. More encounters. Ooh. Hello, Shellos. What have we got that's not going to KO it? Because I definitely want to catch this. I was actually trying to catch one of these in the Grand Underground in my Pearl playthrough, and it took out my entire team because it was level 29 while I was trying to catch it. Okay, that's fairly decent. I don't think I want to add it to the team straight away because it'll get stomped by Skuntank. But yeah, we might add it in there. Being that it's a water type and we don't really have a proper water type. I know we've got Weasel in there, but I don't really want to run with that the whole time. Let's avoid the forest. So let's go heal up, and then we'll also buy some more super potions, just in case, because I really don't want to mess around with this any longer than we have to, because I really want to get on with the rest of the game. Let's go. Okay, third time's a charm, hopefully. can I say? Alright, so that's Zubat out of the way. Here comes the flamethrowers. Unfortunately, we're going to faint because of the stupid poison. Wow. Thanks for doing not much damage, mate. Let's try and get it paralyzed, huh? Oh, man. Really? Let's try and get off a wing attack. Can this thing just please die? I'm not even going to rely on throwing out Grottle, because seriously. Just throw out a quick attack, huh? Huh. Hey, we won at least. Wow, that took way longer than I thought it would. Let's go visit him at the cycle shop because we need him to give us the bike to go on the cycle way. Alright, and while we remember, let's make a few adjustments to our team. Let's bring Kadabra back in. Zubat back in. Cycle shop is here. Let's go with red on pearl, so let's go with blue for diamond. Cool. I know from experience. And here's our good friend Rourke. So yeah, so it's a big network down here, but if we go over to the right here, I think this was like the water area. Okay, yeah, so it stayed the same. So there's, there's a few different things. Psyducks. Is that a Lickitung walking around? But yeah, I'll show you what I meant by. Please tell me that was the Lickitung. Yeah, okay. So if this thing starts to rip through the entire team, we'll just bail out, but yeah, so see how it's level 28, so it's a fairly high level compared to what we've got, and that did barely anything. So did that. Let's get back to doing this, hopefully we can paralyze it. lots of flinches. Okay, so what I want to do is get it down to really low health to try and see like if we can actually catch this. Because I wasn't able to catch them in Pearl. Okay, so well, let's see what happens. Yeah, see, look. Either it's super hard to catch, or we're not able to catch them down here yet. Let's try that again. Yeah, I think it's, let's just heal up. Let's try it one more time to see if we can get a couple of levels. No. Okay. This battle's been dragging on forever. Well then, okay, yeah, so that's what the Grand Underground has to offer, which was interesting. Sorry about my chair just then. No, no, stay away, stay away. Alright. So yeah, so push Y to go turn to the surface. Go back in here and heal, and then we want to head south, I think. Never tried the D-pad on here before. So that's how you walk slowly, huh? Yeah, let's do as much battling as we can, I say. After our last couple of encounters with both Galactic and the gym leaders where we've struggled, I think we need to train our team up a bit. someone we can battle. Yeah. What happened to our Intimidate? Hey, a Ponyta. Come on, just faint. What I like to see. Forgot that I missed that guy. That lady, sorry. Not to tell under the helmet and all that. Good, at least it didn't growl me this time. So many people. Probably best not to use Thundershock. Counter this person. And my attack is cut again. Someone here? I think I did. Yeah. Okay, I think that's enough of those cyclists, huh? No, we're right at the end anyway, that's good. Let's see, I picked right, so let's pick left, huh? Oh. Oh yeah, I haven't really had that screen out. Okay, I haven't seen the old Barry in a while. Alright, so I think we're just about to reach Heart Home. But yeah, so let's just... Okay, we'll battle these ones. Sure, why not? Speed increase isn't good though. Weird that they aren't picking on Luxio, because Luxio has lower health. Yep, you lost. Alright, so... Oh, right, that's what those things are. A super potion, thank you. To a guy who's probably going to throw out some stuff here. Out of the way. Oh, that's not going to do much. Oops. Bite's probably not going to do much either, come to think of it. Oh no, that's good. Okay, so I think on the other side of this cave is where we need to be. Yep. And that's Mount Coronet in between us. So yeah, we are just going to leave it here for today. Thank you very much for watching. And yeah, next time we will do the third gym. Hopefully we get through it a lot quicker than the first two. And thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next one. See ya.